videos. In this video, I am explaining the permutations and combinations MZ problems, and the students who will follow these videos will definitely get very good marks in the coming MZ examination. So all of you watch the videos, make the notes, practice the sums, okay? And in the description, I am giving the link of the practice problems of the permutations and combinations PDF. So all of you, after watching the video, once open the description and see the PDF and solve those questions also. Those are also very, very important sums. Okay, let us start the class. This is sum number 65. The question is, the number of numbers greater than or equals to 1000 but less than 4000 that can be formed with the digit 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 so that any digit may be repeated is. So, we want the number of numbers that are greater than 1000 and less than 4000. That is, we want the 4-digit number which are formed by these digits, by using these digits. We want to form the numbers by using these digits. We want the numbers which are greater than 1000 and less than 4000. Okay, that is, greater than 1000 means first of all we can fill the first gap in 3 ways, either by 1 or 2 or 3. Okay, we don't take here 4 since we want the number which is less than 4000. So we don't take 4 here and we don't, obviously we don't take 0 here. Okay, so we can fill the first gap in 3 ways. Understand? Now, here repetition is allowed, that is we can fill the second gap in 5 ways. Okay, since here we have the 5 digits, and we can fill the third gap in 5 ways since here we have the 5 digits, and we can fill the last gap in 5 ways. That's all. Therefore the answer is equal to 5 into 5 into 5 into 3, and that is equal to 375. That's all. This is the answer, and that is the second option. Next problem, sum number 66. The sum of all 3-digit numbers that can be formed by using the digits 1 to 9, and when the middle term is a perfect square, repetitions are allowed. Okay, okay, listen. What is the question? The sum of the 3-digit numbers which are formed by using the numbers 1 to 9. Okay, we want the sum of the 3-digit numbers. For that, first we want the 3-digit numbers. After taking the 3-digit numbers, we have to add those numbers. Okay, sum of the 3-digit numbers means, first of all, we want the 3-digit numbers. And what is the condition? Here, always the middle digit is a perfect square. Okay, okay, listen, repetition is allowed. Okay, listen, we can fill the hundreds place in 9 ways. Obviously, we can fill the hundreds place in 9 ways. Either by 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6, 7 or 8, 9. Okay. And similarly, we can fill the units place in 9 ways. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What is the condition for middle digit? Here we have to fill this gap by the only perfect square. That can be done in 3 ways only. What are the numbers perfect square? 1, 4, 9. Okay, we can fill the middle gap by the 3 ways only. That is by 1 or 4 or 9. So we can fill this gap in 3 ways only. Now what is the given question? Sum of the digits. Okay. Now I take that sum of the digits in units place. First I take that sum of the digits in the units place. Okay. What is that value? Okay. Listen. 9 into 3. Just we take the number of possibilities of the hundreds place and tens place. Now what are the numbers in the units place? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Just add all those numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's all. This is the sum of the digits in the units place. Understand? That is equals to 27 into sum of the n natural numbers. N into n plus 1 by 2. That is equals to 27 into 9 into 5. So this is the first value. Understand? Now we want the sum of the digits in the tens place. Okay, listen. So tens place means we can fill the first gap by 9 ways, we can fill the last gap by 9 ways, and we can fill the middle gap in only 3 ways. Okay, now what are the possibilities here? 1, 4, 9. What is the sum of the tens place? Sum of the tens place means we are adding the values in the tens place only. Sum of the digits in the units place means we are adding the numbers in the units place. Sum of the digits in the tens place means we are adding the digits of the tens place. That is, hundreds place numbers is equal to 9, units place numbers is equal to 9. What are the numbers in the tens place? 1, 4, 9. That is 1 plus 4 plus 9. Understand? Into 10. Tens place means we take that into. Now this is 81 into 4. 14 into 10. Okay, so this is the second value, sum of the tens place value. Now we want the sum of the values in the hundreds place. We can fill the first gap in 9 ways, last gap in 9 ways, this gap in 3 ways. Okay, now sum of the values in the hundreds place, sum of the digits in hundreds place. Now this value is equal to, we have to add the numbers in the hundreds place. Sum of the values in the tens place means we are adding the digits of the tens place. Sum of the units, sum of the digits in the units place means we are adding the numbers of the units place. Sum of the digits in the hundreds place means we are adding the digits of the hundreds place. Okay, just take these values first, 3 into 9, okay, into numbers, numbers of the hundreds place, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, okay, just adding all these digits, all possible values here, into, we are taking the hundreds digits, that is into 100, okay. Now this is 27 into 1 plus 2 plus and so 9 is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2, 9 into 10 by 2 into 100. Okay, this is equal to, now adding all these numbers. Okay, listen, what is the first value? 27 into 5 into 9. What is the second value? 27 into 3 into 14 into 5 into 2. Okay, understand, just for the common purpose, for taking the number common, we are converting like that. So this is 27 into 3 into 14 into 5 into 2. And what is the last value? 27 into 9 into 5 into 100. Now taking the common numbers common here, what are common? 27, 5, 27, 5, 27, 5, again 3 also. Okay. So here taking 3 common, that is 27 into 5 into 3. What is the remaining value? Here 3 and here 28 and here 100. Now adding all this value, taking the simplification, then we get the value 55. 1,34,055. That's all. That is the answer and that is the first option. Question sum number 67. The number of different numbers that can be formed by using all the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. So that odd digits always occupy the odd places. Okay, listen. The question is, the number of different numbers that can be formed by using all the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. So the odd digits always occupy the odd places. Okay, listen. So this is a 7 digit number. What are the odd places here? 1, 3, 5, 7. These are the odd places. What are the odd numbers here? 1, 3, 3, 1. What is the given condition? All numbers occupy the odd places. That is, we can fill the 4 odd numbers in the 4 odd places. Okay. We have to fill the 4 odd numbers in the only odd places. That can be done in 4 factorial. And replacing the even numbers in the even places, that is, 3 even numbers can be placed in the 3 places, 3 even places in 3 factorial ways. But here, see here, 1 is repeated twice, that is by 2 factorial. 2 is repeated twice, that is by 2 factorial. 3 is repeated twice, that is by 2 factorial. Therefore, the answer is equal to 4 factorial 24, 3 factorial 6, 2 factorial 2. Therefore, 8 is cancelled by 3 times. So, 6 times is equal to 18. That's all. And that is the last option. And that is the last option. Next question, sum number 68. With 10 different letters, 5 letter words are formed, then the number of words which have at least one letter repeated is equal to. So, given that 10 distinct letters, 5 letter words are formed. So, here 10 letters are given, we have to form the 5 letter words. That is, given that n is equal to 10, r is equal to 5. Total number of letters is equal to 10. We have to form the 5 letter words. That is, r is equal to 5. What is the given question? The number of words which have at least one letter is repeated. At least one letter is repeated. Then what is the formula? The most important formula. The number of arrangements in which at least one letter is repeated is equal to n power r minus npr. Therefore, the answer is 10 power 5 minus 10 pi. That's all. And that is the third option, direct formula. Next question, sum number 69. The number of ways of permuting the letters of the word engineering so that the order of the vowels is not changed. Okay, listen. One word is given here, that is engineering. The number of ways of permuting the letters of the word so that the order of the vowels is not changed. That is, we don't change the order of the vowels here. What is the order of the vowels in the given word? E I E E I. Whatever the position, we have to take the vowels in this order only. Whatever the position, we have to take the vowels in this order only. That is the given question. Okay. So first leave the all vowels. Okay. Leave the all vowels. Just I am taking the 11 gaps here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So first I can fill the remaining 6 consonants in these 11 places. First, I am placing the consonants in the 11 gaps. That is, we can fill the 6 consonants in the 11 gaps. That can be done in 11 pieces. Understand? First, I can fill the 6 consonants in the 11 gaps in 11 pieces. By what are the consonants here? N is repeated thrice and G is repeated twice. In the consonants, G is repeated twice and N is repeated thrice. That is, we take them by 3 factorial, by 2 factorial. R is a single letter, N is repeated thrice. That is 3 factorial. G is repeated twice. That is 2 factorial. So, this is the number of ways of arranging the only consonants. Okay. For suppose, I arranged the consonants like that. N, G, N, R, N, G. Suppose, I arranged like that. Now, in the remaining gaps, I place the vowels like that. E, I, E, E, I. That is, without changing the order, directly I replace the vowels in the remaining gaps. That can be done in only one place. Okay. Here, I placed the remaining vowels like that. Just to fix the vowels like that. That is, arrangement is equal to 1. Now, what is the simplification? 11P6 is equal to 11 into 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6. Understand? By 3 factorial is equal to 6, 2 factorial is equal to 2. Now this is equals to 11P5 by 2 factorial. 11P5 by 2. What is 11 into 10 into 9 into 8 into 7? That is 11P5. So answer is equal to 11P5 by 2, and that is the fourth option. That's all.